Hi everyone, today I am going to explain an FPGA trainer kit. The FPGA trainer kit consists of following parts. One is base band and a daughter board. This is the daughter board and under is an base board, and second part is an programming tool, that is a Xilinx, and a power supply. So here the power supply is given as a 0 to 12 DC. Next we'll see how the base board is designed. So this base board consists of 32 inputs using an 8 ways 4 DP switches. Each input of this switches has an LED indication. These are the LED indication. Whenever I turn on and turn off, the LED will be on and off, and it consists of 32 outputs through which output ports of an FPGA connected to the LED. Next, it consists of 16x2 alphanumeric LCD display with a backlight through 10-pin FRC. So this is the LCD's 10-pin FRC. Next, it consists of 7-segment display connected to the 10-pin FRC connector to an FPGA port pin. Next, it has got a 4x4 key matrix. And it will generate 5 different clock frequencies. That is, this is the clock frequency generator. You can see here, clock generator. It generates 5 different clock frequencies of 10 MHz, 5 MHz, 1 MHz, 500 kHz and 100 kHz. On a board, we have gotten a relay connected. Which is using a 10-pin FRC. And next, this board also consists of a traffic light simulator connected to an FPGA using a 16-pin FRC. And we can do both analog to digital converter and digital to analog converter. So this is an analog to digital converter unit, and this is a digital to analog converter unit. This is digital to analog, and this is analog to digital. Both digital to analog, analog to digitals are using a 16-pin FRC cable to get interface between the modules. And next, by using a digital to analog converter, we can generate different waveforms that will be further discussed in an upcoming sessions. And on board, we have gotten F4 elevators connected to an FPGA using a 16-pin FRC only. And later on, as we go, it has gotten two pin DC motors and then stepper motors, which is used to drive the motors, and these are connected using a 10-pin FRC to the FPGA port. And it has gotten one push button, and it has gotten 4 sets of 20x2 female bare connectors to plug to the, these are the female, this is daughter board. The daughter board is connected to the base board by using a 20x2 female connectors to plug into the daughter board. Now let us see, the program can be downloaded from the PC to the FPGA on the daughter board using a programming tool called as a Xilinx. Here the daughter board, what we are going to use, this is the daughter board. Here we are using a Xilinx XE3S50 FEG. So this daughter board has a non-volatile ROM for a standalone programming, where it has got a JTAG connector for a boundary scan programming, and it has got a mode selection jumpers. This is the mode selection jumpers. You can see here, this is the mode selection jumpers, and then LED indication, which indicates whether a program has been dumped or not. It has got a four set of, as I said that, it has got a four set of 2x2 male, where the baseboard will have a 20x2 female bare connectors, but whereas the daughter board has a 20x2 base 20x2 female bare connectors. Now let us see the hardware description of a baseboard. So in the first part is a 7-segment display. There are 6 7-segment display in a trainer kit. The inputs to the segment A to segment DP, that is decimal point, are the outputs of the FPGA. Any of the 6 digits can be selected using an analog pin 1 to analog pin 4 signals, that is AN1 to AN4 signals. These segments are active high on, active I on, that is they are common cathode type. They are common cathode type. The connection detail of a 7 segment LED displays is as follows, where AN1 is connected to the CN5 of the connector 5, AN2 is connected to the 6, AN3 is connected to the 7, AN4 is connected to the 8, segment 1 is connected to the, that is for a single segment I am saying, segment 1, that is A, is connected to pin 9, B is connected to pin 10, C is connected to pin 11, D is connected to pin 11, E is connected to pin 12, F is connected to pin 13, G is connected to 14, H is connected to 15, and dot is, that is decimal point, is connected to 16. And apart from this, we have gotten two other signals, that is AN5 and AN6, both are connected to 167 pin. And next we'll discuss about the output LEDs. So these are the 32 output LEDs which are connected to the FPGA output ports. These LEDs are active I type, that is they switch on to indicate the logic 1 status. Next part is an input DP switches. There are four DP switches provided on the baseboard, which are connected to the 32 input LEDs, green from LED 1 to LED 32, and to the connectors connected to the daughter board. DIP switches are represented on the baseband board from an DP1 to DP4. You can look over here. DP1 to DP, DP1 to DP1 to DP4. Next is a 4x4 matrix switch. A 4x4 matrix switch. This is a 4x4 matrix switch unit. These 4x4 matrix push buttons are provided on the baseband. These switches could be used as an input to the FPGA through the daughter board connection. Next is an alphanumeric LCD display. This is 16:1 alphanumeric. This is 16:1 alphanumeric LCD display with a backlight is provided on the baseboard. The connection details of this is the RS, that is then read signal, is connected to the CN5 connection of 9. RW is connected to the pin number 10. EI means enable input is connected to the pin number 11, and the data 0, data 1, data 2, data 3 are connected to 12, 13, 14, 15 respectively. And next comes with an traffic light stimulator. There are 4 bipolar LEDs. There are 4 bipolar LEDs L1 to L4, in which one side is connected to green and another side is connected to red. One side is connected to green and another side is connected to red. For an example, if you want red color, you have to make the pin connected to the red side high and the other to low and vice versa. When both are high, it will give an amber color. We have taken the pin representation according to direction from which the vehicle is coming. For an example, the vehicle is coming from south. The vehicle is coming from south. If you want to stop it, then make the pin red. Make the pin red underscore S is I and the pin red underscore S is low. If you want to allow it to go straight, then make the pin green high and the pin red low. And if you want to allow it to go right, then make the pin green to high at the right side. This is at the south, at the right side. If you want to make a driver to get ready, then make the pin red and then pin green to the high. Next comes with an DC motor interface. This is the DC motor interface. This DC motor uses PWM method is used to run the DC motor. Switches is used to control the direction of the DC motor, and DC motor should be connected to the 2-pin relimit connector. And next comes with an stepper motor. We can run a stepper motor which drives up to a 300 milliamp current, but be careful while interfacing stepper connect. The interface has to be directly connected to the power mate connector, that is here. This is the power mate connector, that is PM1. Next comes with another set of a block is called as a clock generator. This is the clock generator unit. The baseboard has 5 different frequencies, as I said in a characteristics, that is 10 megahertz, 5 megahertz, 1 megahertz, 500 megahertz, kilohertz and 100 kilohertz. So if you want to generate the clock 1 and the clock 2 are you generating 10 megahertz, in that clock 1 has the select option for an 5 megahertz. You can see here, this is the clock 1 and the clock 2. So clock 1 has an option or an as in select clock 1 has a select option for an 5 megahertz and an 1 megahertz using a jumpers JP1 and using a jumper JP2, the clock 2 has an option to select 500 kilohertz and an 100 kilohertz. You can look over here on a board. These are the two jumpers, JP1 and then JP2. JP1 and then JP2. Here you can generate. So generate a clock of a mega 5 mega to 1 mega. You have to select and jump JP1. Or if you want to generate a clock 2, it is from an 500 to 100. You need to select then JP2. Next comes with an how to generate the clocks for a desired frequency. So when JP1 pins 1 and 2 are shorted, it will generate in 5 megahertz. When JP1 pin 2 and 3 are shorted, it generates in 1 megahertz. Next, how to generate a clock 2. So the clock 2 is generated by using a jumper 2, that is a JP2 pin 1 and 2 has to be shorted to generate 5 kilohertz, and JP2 pin 2 and 3 has to be shortened to generate 100 kilohertz. Next comes with the daughter board connection. So this is a daughter board. This Spartan 3 family of an FPGA, field programmable gated array, is specifically designed to meet the needs of an high volume, cost sensitive consumer electronics application. The 8 number family offers a density range from 50,000 to 5 million system gates. Because of their expectational low cost, Spartan 3 FPGA are ideally situated to a wide range of consumer electronics application, including an broadband access, home networking, display or projection, and digital television equipments. The features of daughter boards are, it is belongs to then a family XC3S50 with a pin package of 208 of a Xilinx. It has a 50K system, that is 50 kilo system gates. It consists of 1728 logic cells and it employs a 12 kilo distributed RAM. It has also got an 72 kilo block RAM. It is an FPGA IC in an PQFP208 pin package with 124 input and output lines. The feature of daughter board, it has gotten a push button switch programmed to initiate the FPGA during a master serial mode. Optional, it has gotten PROM. Four set of 20x2 bearer connector for plugging on the baseboard. It has got a mode selection, that is a JP1, and it has got a power supply of 3.3 volts, 2.5 volts and 1.2 volts are provided from the baseband. This Spartan 3 FPGA Xilinx uses a SRAM technology which supports both serial configuration using a master's or slave series, and it has got a JTAG mode as well as byte wide configuration employed with the slave parallel mode. It also supports the four configuration modes, that is slave serial mode, master serial mode, slave parallel mode and boundary scan mode. In our whole experiment we use an boundary scan mode. So this is a simple introduction of an FPGA kit along with the daughter board. Thank you.